All right, so this is going to be basically the first test run of the new Canon Vixia HFR 800 camera that I got for Christmas. And eventually the videos is all going to be done with this camera. I picked this one out for a particular reason. It does have a stereo mic input jack on it. And I'm in the process of making a little converter for switching the mixer over from line level to mic level, so we can feed all the audio into the camera, just like I was doing with my phone. I made a same type of converter that would work with my phone, so I could plug the mixer in. The only downside of that was that it was a mono mic input, so you were always going to hear the audio in mono. It was never going to be in stereo. Well, now we can have it in stereo. And since I was doing this basically just as a test, just to see how the camera does, I've already uploaded a test video to YouTube. It looks pretty good. There's certain things about this that I really like, and there's certain things about it that's not as convenient as my phone. I don't think that the zoom is quite as good as my phone. My phone would go all the way and still be in focus. This doesn't make it quite all the way, and you know, of course, there's a mechanical switch here for the zoom versus on my phone. I just swipe it with my finger. So there's some pluses and some minuses, but I'm willing to take a little less on the video features to have the stereo audio, because that's obviously something that's pretty important to me. To be able to, you know, when we're working on this audio stuff, to make sure that what's uploaded to YouTube, you're hearing it in two-channel stereo sound. So I figured that for doing the test, I wasn't going to do an official video for this old amplifier that I bought here. And what this is a old 1980 Craig Power Play, and they're calling a 50-watt booster. And I got this, of course, on eBay, and I paid, I think, $13 or $14, and that was with the shipping. And in the seller's description, he had no idea if it worked or not. I think he said he tried it, but he couldn't get it to work. And sure enough, when I got it, it didn't work. But there was a problem in the input voltage circuit. And of course, this was made back in the day when there was no RCA inputs. They just give you some wires to connect your car stereo's speaker outputs directly into this. And so I've made some modifications to it. As you might imagine, I pulled out all of that attenuation circuitry they had there and some of the startup circuitry. I took that out as well, and so now it is running as it should be, just as a straight, you know, preamp level in instead of an attenuated speaker level in. Added a relay for the startup, put a small relay right there so we can start it up with a relay. So basically, just like you're used to, there's a common B plus line that will be at the battery at all times, and then there's a remote line that you'll fire up. And then, of course, that'll activate the relay, which will activate the amplifier. And it's been worked on. It's an old-school two-channel amplifier, obviously transformer output, but it's been rebuilt on one side. And whoever did it did a pretty good job. The outputs that they used are pretty right on with the ones that should be in there. And it's a very loud amplifier, I'll say that. It is a very, very loud amplifier. Got it running off of the higher amperage power supply, because I've actually had this thing bumping up really good in here, and the temperature of it. And this is just the preliminary heat sink they mounted the transistors to. Of course, this heat sink mounts to the case to give it even more. But this thing is nice and loud. Let's bump it up a little bit. The way I've got it running is I'm dumping a signal out of the mixer. The mixer is being used as the preamp, and we're coming in on these two right and left input lines, and the whole thing, speakers, ground, and input ground, is all common. The ground's common to the whole thing. So I've got a couple of speakers jacked into the plate for the bench speakers. And let's see what we got here. We'll listen to the police. Very loud. Probably distorting the shit out of built-in microphones in this camera, but there really isn't any other way to demonstrate how powerful this is but without getting it and driving it into distortion. But this thing is jamming, man. This is a pretty nice little amplifier. And I knew it would be, I was fairly certain that it would be discreet because of the age. And so I bought this more as curiosity, just trying to figure out how they did it, how they put it together. I figured it had some small transistors in it, but this is old school stuff right here, and even the old school cheap shit was better than the new school brand new shit, you know, expensive shit. So very cool amplifier, and again, just thought I'd use that as the test for the new camera, and we'll see once it's uploaded what the video quality is. The sound quality, I've already tested it with the external microphone running through the mixer. It's all sounding very good. The audio is excellent. There's no problem with that. I've worked on, basically what I did was, as I often do, I save a lot of PCBs and stuff that I pull out of things. And so what I did was I took one that I had and constructed a little attenuation circuit. Basically what we're doing is the opposite of what I did here, is instead of going from speaker level to preamp level, we're going to be going from preamp level to mic level. And so I built an attenuation circuit. And so took an old circuit board, just depopulated it, removed all the components off of it. And once I removed all the components off of it, then I just did a Google search for line level to mic level. And there's a couple of different great circuits that they had designed, real simple. And that's what I did, was added a few resistors and some jumper wires, and basically come in from the mixer on RCA, line level, and you come back out 3.5 to mic level that'll go into the camera. And so I got a project case coming for this. I'm going to put this in a project case, do it all up the right way. Got some new cables and some cords and stuff that I'm making so we can do these up the correct way. But yeah, nice old amplifier, super cheap, and gonna install some RCA jacks into the frame here, and don't know what I'll do with it, but couldn't pass it up. Wanted to see how they did it back in the day, and this is how they did it. Hook it up to your 8-track back in your car. A couple of those Jensen triaxial 6x9s, and away you go. So anyway, this will be probably maybe within the next few weeks, the videos will start being made with this, and we'll have the audio I've always wanted to have. As far as the video quality and my navigation of the camera, that will be a learning curve, but we definitely will have the more desired 2-channel stereo audio. So just thought I would throw this in at the end of our regular video this week. And after a little fabricating, the end product is looking like this right here. Basically what I did was took a couple of RCA input connections and put those on the kind of far right edge there. And of course, we use the ones that have the black inner isolator, not red and white. Red and white would not have been proper for back in this time. They hadn't established that yet. And as for the speakers, instead of having the wires come out of the harness, I went ahead and put in a 3-screw terminal board. And again, I think this would have been proper for back then. They would have been some power boosters that would have had a shared ground for the speakers. And so I think it all looks pretty good. It's coming together pretty good. Cleaned up our shell a little bit, and it's starting to look a little bit better. So this is kind of basically how our end product is going to look. Looks real good. Before this wire comes out right here, I had to modify that. Had to cut a chunk of it off just simply because it was overhanging onto the screw terminal board, but that's okay. All it's securing now is just the 3 wires, which is going to be basically the remote turn on, the ground, and the B plus. But yeah, that's all right, little thing. Kind of cool little amplifier. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with it, but definitely come a long way since I took it out of the box that it was poorly packaged in. So, all right, just thought I would share that with you in case anyone's interested in the old car audio stuff.